All right, here we go. Simple stroke again. Just getting a couple of little pieces of lint off the body. You know, you could stop every once in a while and check the work just to make sure that there is no piece of lint or, you know, and again, lacquer in the nail polish is very forgiving. You know, you could stop and then, you know, let's say you get a hair on there or a piece of lint, you can remove it. It's not a problem. Keep a tack cloth and you could remove most of the impurities that will land on the body while you're airbrushing. You see the color going on now. As I said, it takes a while for the coat to build. So you want to hit every angle, every nook and cranny. And again, it's going on very thin, so you have nothing to lose. Take your time. And you see it there, that shimmer is the color going on. It's a very strange color, but very beautiful too. So, and the airbrush is doing a wonderful job of getting an even, smooth coat of paint on everything. So make sure that you get all the crevices. The beauty of painting the car with black primer is that you now have very deep and dark panel lines and recesses. So just keep working on it. Keep going. It takes a while, but it's worth it. And as I said, you could stop if you need a little break or something. You can stop and then come back to it. Always make sure that you shake your paint and you adjust, you know, if you need to. I jumped to show you a little bit of more progress because this has been been going on for 30 minutes. Didn't want to show you the entire process, but you get the idea. Steady strokes, and the color eventually goes on there. Most people are terrified of thinking that they're going to put too much paint on there, and the thickness of the paint is going to obliterate the detail. But that's not true with lacquer and urethanes. It goes on very, very thin, and as a matter of fact, you want to make sure you put enough on there, and you make sure you get all the edges because you don't want to sand through to back to the primer because it's going to show. So you want to keep going and going until you finally get the color saturation you want and desire, and that should do it. Notice how I keep turning the model from side to side, up, down, all around. That could be a song. And you keep adjusting and cleaning the tip. Notice I have a little paper towel in my other hand, so I clean the tip of the needle with it, just to keep the paint flowing smoothly without it spitting or anything like that. This airbrush is really rising to the occasion. So there it is. You stop and check your progress. Make sure that everything looks fine. And let's see what else. And now, of course, coming back to get the hood in the same color, you have to apply more or less the same amount of paint so that you don't end up with a mismatched body and hood. So everything requires the same amount of paint. Anyway, by this point, you get the idea, and the more you do this, the more you practice, the better at it you will get. It requires a little bit of time and effort, like everything else. If it were easy, everybody would be doing it, you know. But, ultimately, it is easy. and you too can do it, so. There we go. It really is a wonderful color. Over on the right, you can see how much paint I've already used just on the body, engine, and the hood. And I always leave a little bit left, so.
All right, everybody, just a little break here to show you what we've got. Now, remember that this kind of color takes a while for it to go on. Remember, you're working against black. And it just turned out that the reason why they call it mysterious blue is because it sort of color shifts on you from a very light blue where the light hits it to a very dark blue. And it's got a little bit of purple in it too. So it's great to know that there's one color out there that achieves the kind of color variation you'd have to put a few other using, for example, House of Color, you might have to end up using something like True Blood or even a little bit of Oriental Candy and maybe what's the name of it, not Aztec Blue, but they have a Cortez Blue, which I've used in the past, but this comes in one color. So we've got, the hood and the car already in what I would call, the first stage of the color of the base coat. Next up is a little bit of fine sanding, probably starting with 4,000 and maybe going all the way to 12. And then another coat, just to make sure we've got a steady color throughout. And then the clear, and whatever other bling I'm going to put on it. So I'm very pleased. And there you go. This is the kind of work you can do with nail polish. So let me know what you think. We'll be right back.